Welcome, friends, to the session which is going to deal with global indicators and how the global indicators affect the flight routes and the travel by flight. My name is Amruta Haldankar and I'm a trainer in aviation, tourism and hospitality. Now we have the 8th GI which is there, that is RU. So we have these areas over here. This will be area 2 and area 3. Okay, there are certain conditions where we are talking about Russia in Europe. The flight will be leaving from Russia in Europe, that is the last point of exit of traffic conference. Area 2 has to be Russia in Europe. It does not include any other countries in Europe. That's the main criteria for this. So it should not be via any other country in Europe. It will be a non-stop journey. So that's one more criteria. And the entry point would be TC3 JAPCOR, that is Japan and with the Koreas. So after that, it may have the ahead journey that will be including TC3, which is other than JAPCOR. So it has exceptions, although there are exceptions, which will be all of this country. So what it means is if the flight is taking place from traffic conference area 3 after JAPCOR, it can go to any other countries except for this country. So these countries are Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Mongolia, Russia and Asia, Tajikistan, Turkmenistan and Uzbekistan. These were right now are in SEA, but they were earlier included in Soviet Union. So this is one exception that we have. So when we are dealing with RU as the GI, we have certain conditions over here. Number one, it has to be Russia and Europe. Russia in Europe. The next one, it cannot be via any other country. It has to be a non-stop journey to JAPCOR, and then it may have any other point in Area 3, provided the point is not in this exceptional countries. So we have these two examples over here. The first one is St. Petersburg, which is in Russia and Europe. It goes to Moscow, which is again Russia and Europe, and further ahead it goes to Osaka, which is a non-stop flight to Japan. So what it means is it is not going across any other country in Europe. Further, there is no other point in traffic conference area 3. So it is a typical example of RU. The next example that we have is again Moscow, which is in Russia in Europe area 2. It goes non-stop to Tokyo, which is in Japan, and further ahead it goes to Taipei, which is not a part of any of these exceptional countries over here. So clearly this is also an example of RU. So these are what RU conditions would be. We have RU on the map, where in St. Petersburg is Russia in Europe. From there, Moscow again Russia in Europe. Non-stop service to Osaka, which is in Japan. So that's first example. The second one is Moscow, which is in Russia. From there, Tokyo again to Japan. That's non-stop service. And from there to Taipei, which is in Area 3, but not the exceptional countries that we had. I hope this session on global indicators was helpful, and it is going to help you in finding out the global indicators if you know ITA areas and sub areas. You may find my profile on LinkedIn if you have any queries about this session. Thank you so much. Have a great day.